as they work against each other. I've been trying to decipher this one of Snyder's here. This is one place where apparently Snyder's particularly vulnerable. He's around his feet and legs. Can't or doesn't like a toehold or a leg lock of any kind. We're almost told alike, but not quite. Tanya may have the edge here. Yep, he's getting it. Press into a hammerlock on Snyder. Newman, I think, is one of the best referees we've had in wrestling ring Chicago in a long time. He stays out of our way. It's body press by Snyder. And tough. There's no love lost between them.
Break it up!
You can hear Gagne there say, break it up. Wrist lock outside and doubled on Gagne. He has a bad elbow on this arm, his left. One that wrestlers don't like particularly because of the dislocations it causes. You, but my elbows and shoulders beginning to hurt. Says it was an open-handed lick, which is permissible, of course. You notice Snyder, he switches from a left to a right-handed wrestler every once in a while. That's what he's trying on Gagne now. And he made it. Lock extended with now and then a Japanese at it. Takedown with a knee drop to the shoulder. boxes them up in great style. Saying, come on, Gagne. Bill Klinke, our boy who makes the sound setups on all of these shows and has ever since we started, finally dreamed up a way of virtually getting down into the middle of the ring with the participants. Without wiring them for sound, that is.
No!
When both ends of Gagne go to flipping, you know he's hurting. That is fully reversed if this keeps up for too long. No one's a great help. He says, give it to him. Japanese wrist lock, in addition to the extension and the twist. This helps when you start bending fingers backwards. Snyder much good. Trying to keep that arm out of the way, but he's not having much luck. Check, check. Well, there's a beauty. Flying toe-ho. Haven't seen that used in a long, long time. Gunny's got to do something to get some rest for this arm, though. Put any toehold pressure on it.